My name is Boniface Mwangi. I'm 29 years old. I'm a photo activist. I run a space for creatives and activists. So this is Power 254.
I think ATI is, let them do it, because I don't want to get involved.
We do lots of stuff here. We organize protests. We do street graffiti, street exhibitions. And we just work in the communities. But this is like our launching pad. This is where we work from. 5 years ago, I was working for a newspaper. As a photographer, the Standard, I was one of the photographers. And after the elections, there was violence. So as a photographer, I was able to document the violence. There was so much happening in the country, from people being shot by police, neighbors killing neighbors, looting, burning of houses. It was so bad. So on this particular occasion, when they reached the driver, they realized it came from the rival community, quote unquote. So they removed him from the car and then they hacked him to death and mugged the people in the matatu. I saw so much violence, but I didn't have time to process because of the adrenaline and the deadlines, and every day I had to shoot and file my images. So there was no time to process. And then now, after 2 months of violence, I went back to like normal life, which was like normalcy. Come to the office, check the docket, go cover a politician. And now I had time to digest and actually process the images that I took. And so they started haunting me. I could hear the screams. I could smell the violence. It was post-traumatic stress. I was extremely stressed. I thought about suicide at that particular time. I was helpless. I didn't know what to do. And I had these nightmares every other day. So I thought, you know what? I should just switch off, stop reading the papers, stop watching TV. Just keep away from politicians, because every time I saw them, I got annoyed.
So Volta Pien, everything is side view.
So what you're trying to do is use the visual art as a tool for activism. Art is our life. Uhuru does art every day. That's what he does every single day. That's what he uses to express himself. So we're not going to stop at that. We are going to ensure that our work continues after the election. Yeah. So the next government should not feel like, oh, we're lucky, we got away and won the elections. I don't think they should be very happy, because you're going to keep reminding them of what they promised to do and what they need to do to ensure the country goes forward. I didn't name any of my kids after my tribe, because I'm trying to find out, we're trying to build a tribeless country. I want my kids to grow up tribeless. They don't have to say, oh, I'm Kikuyu, I'm Luya, I'm Lu, I'm Kalenjin. That's what we're trying to do. The bottom line of everything that I do is so that my kids can grow up in a better country, that they won't be judged by their tribe or by their skin tone, that they don't have to bribe someone to get a job, or my daughter doesn't have to sleep with anyone to get good grades or to get a job. The big day is coming up in March 4th. We have one of the best opportunities to change our leadership in a non-violent way. And that's through the vote. So I think my call to all Kenyans and anyone out there who is actually voting in this election, vote wisely. Let's not vote for tribe.